now an a cappella quartet, the Nylons, best known for such hits as Kiss 'Em Goodbye and Happy Together, were here in Windsor for an encore performance at the Cleary International Center. The Nylons, an a cappella quartet specializing in vocal gymnastics with no band, is comprised of Mark Connors, Claude Morrison, Arnold Robinson, and newest member, Mika Barnes. When did the quartet form?
Many years ago, almost 12 years ago this month, actually. In February of 79. And we were, you know, theater people at the time in between jobs, and so this
resting.
Was a way of being
resting.
Resting, that's right. And so this was sort of a way of keeping creative and keeping our chops in shape. And it just took off from there, you know.
Now, what were either of you doing before you joined the Nylons?
Well, I did a long stint with the Platters. After that, I had a couple of antique shops in Atlanta. Got lots of different things, actually. Actually, I had a management company with a friend of mine in Toronto is how I met the group, actually.
When we got started, I was working in theater as a dancer, you know, freelancing, doing TV shows and regional theater musicals and that sort of thing. And I was sick and in the hospital, actually, and Mark Connors came to me and said, hurry up and get better because we need you for this group we're starting. And I thought, yeah, sure, fine. Well, you know, I'll just do it until I get my dancing legs back, you know. And but it never happened. We just, as
yeah,
I say,
never
it
got
just
his
all
dancing legs back.
There was never any need to. The group just, you know, took off and never looked back.
And how did the name Nylons come up?
Well, actually,
you take it.
Okay. Well, during the 50s and 60s, there were lots of groups named after fabrics, and like the Orlons and the Chiffons, when those fabrics were new, and a lot of other synthetics, you know, and no one had ever used the original synthetic, which was nylon, you know, which is an anagram noted by Claude that for New York and London, it was supposed to be the fiber that stretched from New York to London, N-Y-L-O-N, so that's how it all kind of, we were doing something organic, and we gave it a synthetic name. I think it was the object of it.
It was a joke,
yeah.
Basically.
Bad
it was
joke
kind of, you know, with tongue firmly in cheek.
Yeah.
You know, we just didn't think twice about it. You know, it was a joke, and then by the time we came around to second guessing it, it was a fait accompli. I mean, no one ever forgot that name. We thought, oh, this is a really good name. We stopped to think about it, so we kept it.
Actually, we should take this moment to mention the fact that since the last time we were here, we've had a change of personnel. Paul Cooper left the group to pursue his own personal dreams and desires, and we found this guy a few doors away from where we live on Spadina Avenue. This is Mika Barnes.
And we had been aware of Mika for some time. And you know, our paths occasionally crossed, and so we actually went to him and said, "Would you be interested in auditioning for this?" And it came down to two people, and then you know that was it.
How did you break into the commercial mainstream, or as they say, discovered?
The first break we got was a friend of mine who I'd done a show with was opening up a cabaret in Toronto, And I had invited him to one of the late night parties that we were kind of doing. And he came, saw it, liked it, and he said, listen, I hadn't told you this, but I came here for a reason. And I'm opening up a cabaret, and I want you guys to be the entertainment. So he gave us a budget, and you know, off we went. And how did we break into the mainstream? I think that was through our recording. And by that, we were able to get, you know, television play, radio play, and I think that's how we got to become better known to some Canadians, and a lot of our American audience was through a recording.
Which wasn't a very easy thing to do, because radio tends to put you in their program, and if you're a cappella, that's no spot in there. So for quite a while, we were going along without a record company, I guess a couple of years before. Then it was harder again to get airplay as such, because they didn't have any plates to slot you in, you know. And but the act became popular, I think, by their audiences and by the demand of the audiences. I think they created that slot to put us in and try us out. Yeah.
Now, have you ever been compared to any other musical acts?
Yeah.
Manhattan Transfer, sort of.
New Kids in the Block.
Well, actually, Take Six is an offshoot of, well, we've found out through promoters that we've had in common that we influenced them to get started. So I think more people probably have been influenced off of our successes, whatever they were, you know, to give them impetus to go on and, you know, go through with being a real career person at singing a cappella.
Two top 10 hits and increased airplay has given the Nylons long-deserved recognition.
Having a hit record, you get a lot more attention. The major networks were paying attention to you. So we did Carson, and we did Sajak, we did the first Arsenio Hall show. Lots of different things started to appear because of that, and I think that's what really airplay does, and popularity because of your airplay does.
With several successful albums, the Nylons are ready for the release of their latest project.
It works, you know. It has a lot of different connotations. It speaks of, you know, power, of alive energy, of drive, of, you know, performance.
Shifting.
No, I love the title, but it's going to be a live album, which will include some of the songs for which we're better known, and also about half the material will be stuff that's never been released by us before. So I'm looking forward to seeing it out there.
We'd expect to see the Nylons' next album, appropriately named Four on the Floor, due early this March, followed by another tour. Well, that's it for Local Motion this week. Next week, we'll take a look at another Canadian band, Frozen Ghost, who will make an appearance at St. Clair College. Until then, bye-bye.